with diverse flora and fauna, magnificent natural landscapes, and an ecological biosphere that supports life, this wondrous planet is our earthly home. From our animal co-inhabitants to the lush rainforests and life-giving soil, we cherish all these as gifts from the Creator. It is a common theme in the world's major faiths that during our temporary stay here, we should be good stewards of Mother Earth. Throughout the years, Supreme Master Ching Hai has shared the message of leading a balanced life while following a spiritual path. Not only must we nourish our spirits, but we share the responsibility to care for nature and our fellow beings. In light of recent scientific evidence stressing the grave state of our planet caused by climate change, Supreme Master Ching Hai affirms the important message she has noted for over the past two decades. We must be vegetarian, meaning an animal-free diet and practice sustainable living. Today we present to you Supreme Master Ching Hai's discussion on climate change, titled Going in the Noble Direction, via video conference with our association members in Auckland, New Zealand, on August the 19th, 2008.
Hello, Master.
Hello, all the beautiful people.
All the beautiful people of New Zealand, greeting to you.
Oh, greetings to you, Master, from New Zealand.
How are you?
We are very happy to be with you this evening. Thank you, Master.
All right. Tell me, what is it you want to talk to me about?
We have some questions for you, Master. Here is the first question.
Hi, Master.
Hello.
I'm sure you know that New Zealand is a dairy farming nation to the point that the government did their best to make sure New Zealanders purchased dairy products like butter, etc. In fact, in the early 1970s, a medical certificate was needed in New Zealand to purchase margarine, a non-dairy butter substitute. Therefore, many people defend meat production because they say it is necessary for the well-being and future of the country and its people. How should we reply to this? Also, there are about 4.4 million people here in New Zealand. How many vegetarians are needed here so as to keep New Zealand safe in the coming earth changes? Thank you, Master.
Sometimes I go to the supermarket, I see that, okay, this cheese and that butter next to the non-dairy butter section. They say, this come from New Zealand, that come from New Zealand, but I really did not know to such extent that you even need a certificate to buy a margarine.
Yes, Master.
I truly like that.
Up until the mid-1970s, yes, it was.
Okay, and now no more, right?
That's correct.
Ah, then why we bring up the past?
Just a point of fact, Master.
I'm not New Zealander, but the thing is, you know, we just do our best, you know. There's not much I can tell you except disseminating the, you know, the information for the people and see how they will think about it, you know, in their own time. And also, you know, maybe you have to talk to the government because if the government are the one who endorse meat diet, then they are the one who might be willing to record this, yeah? I'm sure your government has also meant well, because up to recent years, not many governments or anyone have been truly informed about the detrimental effect of meat diet and what all go in the meat that they eat. You see, it's horrible what they're going to eat if they know what it is. All kind of recycling, you know, cow feeding back to cows, and they even use dog, cats, whatnot, you know. wild dead animals to feed the cows and everything, and go back into feeding the pets, and you know, it's all terribly wrong. The way the meat industry is going around to feed people. And that's why, you know, all this has incurred a lot of toil on the people's health. And that bred many incurable disease and so makes a lot of suffering for the meat consumers. But I am sure your government wasn't well informed about this. For example, the government are just reading at the other end of the report, yes? And they cannot just go to every cow and check and every farm and check every day to see what they've been fed. And if they have not been reported about the truth, about how the cow has been fed or raised, then the government also cannot really understand the depth of the trouble. Yeah? So now maybe you could, for example, they rebroadcast the LA conference in which Mr. Howard Lindman, yes, he was a farmer breeding cattle himself, and he has been telling terrible truths about cattle raising and feeding. You could even copy the essential details about his talk, coupled with many other facts that we have gathered at the SupremeMasterTV.com, and you printed them out and maybe send it to the government or present it to them in person if you can. You know, do whatever you can. Make it short, simple, easy to read. And interesting, because the government personnel, they have to read a lot of information every day, you know, all kind of reports. So if your report is eye-catching enough, then maybe they read it. Anyway, try your best, yeah, and inform your people. That's all we can do, because they have been indoctrinated too long. It's not their fault. Nobody's fault. The industry have been feeding them wrong information, and they are to be really pity, yeah? Not to be blamed, not to blame the government, not to blame the people. The information have now, slowly, gradually, going to a different direction, also into some of the governmental agency, but it takes some time for them to realize it also, yeah? After being informed in an opposite direction for so long, even now, if they are informed the truth, you know, it also takes them some time to digest, okay? Just keep doing it. I'm very sorry that it's a hard job for you, but it's a hard job for everyone everywhere. And concerning about 4.4 million people of your nation and how many should be vegetarian, it's like everywhere else, honey. It's 2/3, okay? Meaning 2/3 of the population to be vegetarian, okay?
Yes, thank you, Master. I'd just like to say you look very beautiful.
thank you.
And I love you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. I love you too, love. Thanks for concerning so much. I feel your love for your people, and I'm very touched, and I do hope that we will make it, okay? Not just for New Zealand, but for every country.
Some of the diseases related to meat consumption and or production: swine flu, Ebola Reston virus. Cured meats and fish increase leukemia risk in children. Antibiotic-resistant superbug infections from a strain of Staphylococcus aureus. Blue tongue disease, E. coli, Salmonella, bird flu, mad cow disease or Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, 90% of the population at risk. Pig's disease or PMWS, listeriosis, shellfish poisoning, preeclampsia, Campylobacter, Clostridium difficile, diseases hidden in healthy appearing livestock. Some of the costs of meat eating. Infertility. Eating just one serving of meat per day increases the risk of women's infertility by 32%, with additional meat consumption increasing the risk. Heart disease. Over 17 million lives lost globally each year. cost of cardiovascular disease is at least $1 trillion US a year. Cancer, colon rectal cancer, over 1 million new colon cancer patients diagnosed each year, more than 600,000 colon cancer-related mortalities annually. In the United States alone, colon cancer treatment costs about $6.5 billion US. Millions of people are newly diagnosed with other meat-related cancers every year. Diabetes. 246 million people are affected worldwide. An estimated $174 billion spent each year on treatment in just the United States. Obesity. Worldwide, 1.6 billion adults are overweight, with 400 million more who are obese. Costs $93 billion each year for medical expenses in the United States alone. At least 2.6 million people die annually from problems related to being overweight or obese. Environmental. Use up to 70% of clean water. Pollute most of the water bodies. Deforest the lungs of the earth. Uses up to 43% of the world's cereal. Uses up to 85% of the world's soy. Cause world hunger and wars. 80% cause of global warming. Plus more.
Some of the costs of milk consumption. Bacterial microbes, pesticides and enzymes found in cheese derived from the inner stomach linings of other animals. Up to 80% of the calories in cheese are from pure fat. Breast, prostate and testicular cancer from hormones present in milk. Listeria and Crohn's disease. Hormones and saturated fat leads to osteoporosis, obesity, diabetes and heart disease. Linked to higher incidences of multiple sclerosis. Classified as a major allergen, lactose intolerance, plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers.
Hello, Master. Thank you. Dear Master, weather patterns seem to be changing such that the production of meat is becoming more difficult. Is this going to be a continuing trend to thus force farmers away from various forms of animal husbandry, animal farming? Thank you, Master.
I hope so. Of course, you know, the changing pattern of weather affecting everything else as well. But I think it affects more of the husbandry, yeah? The animal raising way of life. Now, because animals raising takes a lot of water, yeah? More than even a growing vegetable. So if we are short of water, then of course the livestock industry will become automatically minimized. And I hope it will be zero soon. Because the more they raise animals, the more water they need. And the more water they need, the less water we even have for vegetarian food production, like growing crops and all that. So I hope everyone realizes it.
Thank you, Master.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Thank you for having this conference for us. Dear Master, due to political and economic pressure, many leaders do not address the problem of meat eating directly. What encouragement can we give them to stand up and spread the message to the people to be vegetarian? Thank you, Master.
I think they will have to in time, and I hope they do it soon so that we still have a chance to save millions, billions of people on the whole planet. What is the use of having economy or political power when everybody is dead? Even if the leader is still alive, whom would he or she rule if there's no citizen left?
Some of the benefits of a vegetarian diet: lowers blood pressure, lowers cholesterol levels, reduces type 2 diabetes, prevents stroke conditions, reverses atherosclerosis, reduces heart disease risk 50%, reduces heart surgery risk 80%, prevents many forms of cancer, stronger immune system, increases life expectancy up to 15 years, higher IQ, saves 70% of the total cost of $40 trillion for reducing global warming, uses 4.5 times less land to grow food, conserves up to 70% clean water, saves 80% of the cleared Amazonian rainforest from animal grazing. A solution for world hunger. Free up 3.4 billion hectares of land. Free up 760 million tons of grain every year, half the world's grain supply. Consumes one-third fossil fuels of those used for meat production. Reduces pollution from untreated animal waste. Maintains cleaner air. Saves 4.5 tons of emissions per U.S. household per year. Stop 80% of global warming. Plus more. Save your life. Be veg. Go green.
I am worried about your country. It's a small island surrounded by water. And if the water level rises, then I don't want to talk about it. But I'm sure your leader will realize it sooner or later that survival is number one. Political position, economic power is number 10. You know, very low down there. First, we have to survive. Okay? Yes. I'm sure your leaders are not unintelligent. Sooner or later, they will make a decision, and it will be good for New Zealand people. And your power does work also. You write to the government. You get signatures from everybody and submit it to the government. Make noise. Do something. Wake them up. Make them know your choice. Okay? Because the government are the one who should work for the people. So if you tell them, I'm sure they will capisce. All right?
Yes, Master.
Yes. It's not even in my power to influence people's mind. We cannot do that. Everyone has to wake up themselves. Of course, we can use spiritual merit and grace from heaven to uplift the consciousness of humankind to some certain extent, yeah? But we cannot overdo it. So the power has to come from the people. The people have to wake up themselves and decide for the compassionate direction. In that way, it helps them tremendously to elevate their spiritual consciousness. And they will be higher up in heaven after this lifetime, or even during this lifetime already. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Master.
Do something. Tell them, be wise, go green, save the planet.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Dear Master, I feel the most of the New Zealand people are actually quite honest, kind, and also very charitable. The government is also very clean and democratic.
Correct.
So as a nation, I feel we are very blessed up to now, even though there's only a small percentage of vegetarian. So I was wondering, is there any link between the morality and the spirituality? Do moral people also receive the same blessing, protection as spiritual people? Thank you, Master.
Not the same, honey, not the same. Moral people are protected somewhat, but less than the spiritual people, because spiritual practitioners like yourself are connected with a higher level of consciousness. Therefore, the lower level of consciousness hardly can touch you. If you move to the third level, at least middle third, I don't mean the lower third. Lower third, they still can touch you sometimes because you are still connected with the second level. And the second level is next to the astral level. You see what I mean? Astral level next to physical level. Therefore, the higher you are, the further you are from the physical and astral level, the better for you. Now, the people on the lower level of the third level of consciousness, you know, like next to the second level or between our border, you know, nearby, sometimes they still can get trouble with the second level of consciousness. They come up and down. You know, like a bordering country, they can go back and forth a little bit, yeah? But the middle level of the third plane, then the negative power is difficult to get you, unless you go down sometimes, all right. If you stabilize yourself from the middle third at least, then you are safer. You're more protected from this kind of collective bad karmic consequences on a grand scale of destruction. The people from the middle third upward will be surely protected. But the people lower level than that is not. Now then, the moral standard of the world, for example, you don't kill, you don't steal, you don't commit adultery, you don't take intoxicant and all that. These are human moral standard. If you are keeping this moral standard, like the five precepts that I give to you, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not tell lie, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not take intoxicant, yeah, like drug, alcohol, and cigarette, etc. Then, in this lifetime, you will have a healthy life, yeah? You have a good relationship with all the humans, or most of the humans, and have family happiness and all that. That's natural. And also you'll be protected from some small disaster.
Some of the tragic tolls of alcohol. 2.3 million alcohol-related deaths per year worldwide. Cost of alcohol-related illnesses. $186.4 billion U.S. dollars in the United States. Up to $210 to $665 billion U.S. dollars globally.
Disease. Higher amounts of alcohol increase the cancer risk. Even half a glass of wine daily increases the risk of mouth or throat cancer by 168%. Cancer of the liver, breast, colon, esophagus, rectum. Liver disease. Cardiovascular disease, metal toxicity, brain damage, amnesia and dementia, brain shrinkage.
Organ failure, heart, liver, kidneys, stomach, pancreas, eyes.
Birth defects, mental retardation, fetal alcohol syndrome, stunted growth, facial deformity, sudden infant death syndrome, miscarriage.
Alcohol-related violence. Child abuse, 50% of cases. Violence toward loved ones, 30% of cases. Violent acts, 40 to 80% of cases. Suicides, 20 to 50% of cases. Plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers.
Some of the tragic tolls of addictive drug abuse. Over 200,000 deaths each year. Costs of $181 billion U.S. dollars each year in the United States. $33 billion U.S. dollars in the U.K. Lifetime cost of current drug addiction amounts to $575 billion U.S. dollars in the U.K. Harmful effects, brain damage, stroke, heart disease, liver disease, tuberculosis, emphysema, cancer, depression, suicide, permanent memory loss, mental illness, higher infant mortality, increased crime and violence, impotence. Crime and violence. Illegal drugs are a factor in 50% of burglaries in the United Kingdom each year. In the U.S., 60% of people arrested each year have been taking illegal drugs. 650 heroin addicts in the U.S. committed 70,000 crimes in a three-month period. Social costs. U.S. businesses lose $100 billion U.S. dollars per year due to employees' drug and alcohol abuse. Australians pay $53 billion U.S. dollars per year for healthcare, law enforcement, and lost productivity of drug users. Environmental costs. Every gram of cocaine produced destroys 4.4 square meters of rainforest, with 300,000 hectares of rainforest lost each year to cocaine production. Death. 52 people die each day due to drugs in the U.S. In Canada, substance abuse is attributed to 21% of total deaths and 23% of potential life years lost due to early mortalities. Plus more. For more urgent information, please visit www.SupremeMasterTV.com/killers.
Some of the tragic tolls of tobacco. 5.4 million smoking-related deaths per year worldwide. Cost of smoking-related illnesses. $96 billion in the United States alone. Light and mild cigarettes just as harmful. Causes cancer and diseases in animal companions. Speeds the aging process. Toxic residues of third-hand smoke. Heart disease, coronary thrombosis, cerebral thrombosis, kidney failure, cancer, lung cancer, esophagus cancer, kidneys cancer, bladder cancer, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, emphysema, bronchitis, stroke, impotence, additional harms for secondhand smoking, childhood arteriosclerosis leading to heart attacks and strokes in adulthood. Sudden infant death syndrome, infertility, miscarriages and premature deliveries, childhood asthma, bronchitis, ear infection, cleft lip or palate, hyperactivity and aggression in asthmatic boys, circulatory problems in women, plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.SupremeMasterTV.com/killers.
You're not necessarily go up to the higher level of consciousness yet. But by doing this, by keeping the five precepts, even if you're not spiritual practitioners, by keeping the five precepts, when a powerful living master is on earth, in the same period that you are living on earth, he, she can uplift you to the third level, at least lower third level, because you're good enough. The master has excuses to help you. But nevertheless, it's not 100% sure, like you, practice connection with heaven yourself. You know, you own the car, you go wherever you want, whenever you want. And the guy who hitchhike, you can give him a lift, yeah? Of course you can. But you can't take him everywhere he wants to go 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That's the difference. Okay, love? Mm.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I just thought it because I feel a lot of New Zealand people are actually quite kind, you know, compared where I used to be.
Yes, they are.
That's why I ask this question.
Of course, of course. They are very kind and good. And the government is very good. That's why you have to help them. That's why we are helping them. We make television, we disseminate information to let them know that you are so good, you deserve better. Please understand that the meat that you're taking is no good for you. It's no good for you now, no good for you later after you die, no good for the whole planet, no good for your country, no good for your future generation. That's why we have to work hard to help these good people. Because they are good. They deserve to know the truth. They deserve to know better. That's why, okay? If you think they are good, work harder for them.
Yes, yes, thanks.
Thank you.
I feel we also have very good Prime Minister too. Thank
yes,
you.
I know, I know. She's good, good. We feature her often on our Supreme Master television because she's good. Do you watch the Supreme Master TV on D2?
Yes, yes.
Then, you know, we feature your Prime Minister because she was trying to resuscitate the tour guide in a very high mountain. In such a desperate situation. Even she does it personally. You know, how many prime ministers in the world would do that?
Yes, she always tried to look after the needy and the poor.
Yes, I know. So you have to tell your government, tell her more the truth that maybe she's has been too busy to know, because sometimes as the head of the state, she has to go here, go there often, you know, and she doesn't have enough time to peruse over all the information. Sometimes her subordinate stop the information before it comes to her because they think it's not important. It's more urgent, you know, everywhere else, the war in Sudan, the war in Iraq, the war in anything else. or some other prime minister coming to visit, some president is inviting her, etc., etc. They think these are maybe more important than the vegetarian diet information, and they think that is more important than the harmful of the meat diet and how it causes the global warming and how it causes people suffering and death every day.
Yes, yes, yeah.
She has other people who work for assistant and all that, and sometimes their judgment are not the prime minister judgment. They have prioritizing things which are not always the good priority. Okay? You help whatever you can. Tell her directly, write to her again, again, again. Use anything possible, connection, to let her know and to let the government know. Help them because
yes,
they're good.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Since most people on the planet have been raised to a higher spiritual level, what happens to people who die at the moment and in the future?
They will go to where they belong. If they are already very highly spiritually minded, then they'll be uplifted even higher, yeah? Then they will go to third level, you know, at least the third level, low third level or middle third level. It depends on how they react in life, on how they lead their life, and how spiritually minded they were during their lifetime on earth, yeah? And the one who listen, the one who at least keep moral standard, the one who have good heart and honesty and have no intention to harm anyone while they're living, at least, they'll be uplifted to the third level. And then from there, they will have to continue their spiritual journey, or maybe they come back to a better planet and continue their spiritual journey from there. But the people who are truly immoral, who are truly bent on the opposite direction of goodness, they will just have to relearn their lesson somewhere else, more suffering, more painful, okay? Until they wake up, until they all cleanse out of the negative thing that attached to their subconsciousness, have to be all cleaned out before they can be reborn as a human again, or not even. Or even maybe vicious animals, until they really learn to be their great self again, which takes a long, long time. That's why we have to try to save them while they are alive. Give them more time to return to their great self, more time to go into the virtuous direction in a noble life. Because if they die right now, if they die in such a state of lower level of consciousness, they will not go nowhere. Nobody can help them too much after they die. And they will suffer more, seeing the horrible things that they have done in all their lifetime and in this lifetime. They will suffer so much, the mental agony that nobody can even comfort them, because they have to undergo this suffering in order to understand.
Yes, Master.
I'm so sorry that some people are like that. That's why we're trying hard to save them, not because of their physical life, but it is because of the greatness of their soul that is attached to their physical life. And if we don't give them more time to awaken, then they will suffer even more.
Yes, Master.
So I do hope everybody gets saved and have more time to reflect on their own great nature.
Thank you, Master.
If you want to help them, distribute the flyers. Introduce Supreme Master Television and talk to the government, talk to the people, do what you can. Thank you.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome, my love. You're welcome.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Can you please tell us how much time until we reach the point of critical mass, where enough people have turned vegetarian to save the planet? Thank you, Master.
The critical mass is just the beginning. It's not the end. Critical mass point means that we have enough vegetarian spirit, enough vegetarian people energy to reawaken other people around them. So every country has to have enough people to reach this critical mass. And then it will go by itself, yeah? Like the influence, the positive energy will wake up other people around them. And then will be more and more people joining vegetarian diet. And then, you know, the planet will be saved by this positive, benevolent energy.
Yes. Thank you, Master.
You're welcome.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Master, if more people became vegetarian or vegan, that the critical mass would be reached. Do we still need 2/3 of the world's population to become vegetarian in order to save the planet? And if we reach critical mass, how quickly will the rest of the world's population awaken to the need to become vegetarian? Will it be a quick awakening? Thank you, Master.
Critical mass means only the beginning, okay? And we still need 2/3 of the planet, minimum, to be vegetarian in order to change the direction of the climate, restore the order of the earth, repair the damage that we have done to the planet. So we still need the 2/3 quotation. And I just hope that after we reach the critical mass, maybe within 2 years and a half, 3 years, the planet population will be mostly influenced by this critical mass energy. And then we might be happy then. I hope it's quick, yeah? We have not even reached the critical mass yet. But I'm happy to tell you that we are almost there.
Thank you so much, Master.
Work harder. Every day, more new vegetarian members. Every day, every day.
Dear Master, knowing that we have limited time left due to the effects of global warming, I was wondering what to do, as I understand that we should not leave the world being in debt. So, should I work full-time to pay off my debts and meditate less, or should I work part-time to meditate more and forget about my debts? And what happens if we still owe the debt? Where do we go to repay it if the world is not there anymore? Thank you, Master.
I don't know how much you own. It depends. Huh? If you own billions of dollars, I think you have to work many more lifetimes to pay, no? The thing is, I have also advised you how to live simple life, yeah? If you can't afford a house, don't bother buying it. And if you already bought the house and you think that you have too much debt, and you just sell it, and you move in into smaller apartment, smaller house, or just a studio, it depends on how many people. Or if you're single and no tie attached, you can go live with another initiate together in one apartment. There's no need for one person to have 3-4 rooms, or 2 rooms apartment even, yeah? Just do according to your budget, yeah? Live according to your mean. That's the best way to live. I have always lived that way. I don't know why you have to incur debt to buy house or anything else.
It was a student loan, Master.
Well, then you have to work to pay for it.
Okay. Thank you.
You meditate more, you still have debt. You know, the physical debt you had to pay. There's no running away from our obligation, especially when you yourself incurred it. You have to pay for it, okay? You have to work more, or you have to eat less, you have to live in a tent, whatever. Work, save money, pay as quick as possible. That's what it is.
Thank you, Master.
Cut down your expenses to the minimum so that you can pay your debt quickly. Hmm?
Yes, thanks, Master.
Think of the way to do it. For example, if you live too far away from your work and you need a car, and then you move to somewhere next to your work so you can walk every day, or you go by bus to work to save the money for insurance, for car, for petrol, in order to pay more for the debt, yeah? Instead of living in 2-3-room apartment, you go live in a studio, or, you know, as cheap as possible, as long as you can survive. so that you save more money to pay for the debt. There are many ways we can pay the debt. Yeah? Eat at home, don't eat too much outside. Because eat outside is more expensive, eat at home is cheaper. Or live with another initiate to save even more money. Do sponge bath or whatever for a couple of years. Live by your means. Live to, you know, minimum only to survive. And you save all the money you can save to pay off the debt.
Yes.
It's no good going out smelling all the best perfume and then your account is minus 10,000. Try to be frugal and then you will pay your debt quicker, okay?
Yes, Master. Thank you.
Good luck. In USA, there was a millionaire. You know how he became millionaire? You read the story of the Vietnamese who has become millionaire in the United States? He was a millionaire in Vietnam, multi-millionaire already. But he went abroad, became a refugee, yeah? And then he lost everything, of course, when he left. It's a true story, yeah? He settled in America and he has nothing at all. So he has to work for his cousin in a bakery shop, selling bread and cakes and all that. So for several years, I can't remember how many years, but it's not more than 4 years. He lived at the back room of the bakery shop with the permission of his cousin, also to guard the shop. And he and his wife, even two of them, lived at the back of the bakery, belonged to his cousin, so that they don't have to pay rent. And they don't have to pay for car or bus or nothing. And they eat very simple together there. And they take sponge baths for all those years. They save every penny they can. And within 3 or 4 years, he bought the bakery shop from his cousin, become the owner, and continue doing sponge bath and live on the back of the bakery. A multimillionaire who has been used to with money and with servants and with you know, respect and service everywhere in Vietnam. He started from zero, below zero even. And then he bought the bakery shop and then diligently working, not even renting a room yet. Continue live with a sponge bath, you know what I mean? From the sink, bathing from the sink. And then continue with his wife like that and saving every little penny they can. Eat simple, wear simple clothes, never buy anything expensive, just secondhand or maybe just wear the same clothes for a long time. So after a while, he bought another bakery shop and another bakery shop, and so on and so forth, and he become millionaire again in no time. It's a true story of a Vietnamese refugee in the United States. I think it's in California. Okay, so now, if I have told you to live with your initiate brothers and sisters to save your money and, you know, walk wherever you can and go on bus wherever you can, you must reorganize your priority in life. Which one is better, freedom from debt or living a life of, you know, luxury or having a worry at the back of your mind all the time? Anyway, even if you can live together with an initiate or a small apartment or anywhere you can, it's already much better than many refugees. Think of the people who have much less than we, okay? And they survive. So whatever is your circumstance, you're already on top of the world.
Okay, Master, thanks. Hello, Master.
Hello.
Would you please allow me to thank you for all you have done in my life? Because you repair my heart, my emotions, and make me happy, healthy, and whole by your deepest sacred love. All because of you, I am able to face the worldly life and have the courage to face it. It's you who supports the whole sky of my life. I thank you from the bottom of my heart and soul. My question is, I have a 7-year-old son who loves Master very much, always eats vegetarian food when he's with me, but his dad is not vegetarian and offers him meat and non-vegetarian food when they are together. Dear Master, what should I do under such circumstances? How can I protect my child from eating meat, though not much. Thank you, Master.
You and your husband are not together.
We are together right now. I mean, dinner time when he came back from work, he offered non-vegetarian food to my son.
You cook non-vegetarian food at home?
He cook for himself and my son.
Why don't you cook?
I cook vegetarian food for all the family.
And he doesn't eat it?
He eat a little bit only, because he mainly eats non-vegetarian meat.
I understand. You don't give him all the information about the harmful effect of meat diet from the scientists' research?
He's very strong-minded. I don't think he can believe it right now.
If you want to talk to somebody, you have to talk from his point of view. And you don't even need to talk. You print out all the information from the Supreme Master TV about the harmful effect of the meat diet from the scientists' point of view. And you talk to him sweetly, like, I understand that you want our son to be healthy and intelligent. But I read in the research of the scientists, it is like this, like that, like that. Why don't you please just have a look at it and tell me what do you think? You don't just force your opinion on him. You are more strong-minded than him. I mean, it's okay to be more strong-minded in a spiritual way. But when you want to convince somebody, you have to be on his side first. You have to be good to him.
Understand.
You have to be good and sweet, and you have to be more humble. It's good that he still live with you and let you eat vegetarian even. I mean, some husband would try to make trouble for a wife if she is vegetarian, but he doesn't. At least he let you free, and this is very good of him already. So now, you have to tell your son that if you don't like to eat meat, you have to tell your father, I don't want it, and cry out and go out, whatever. And then after a while, your husband will get used to it and don't try to force the son anymore. You have to talk to your son. Tell him you are 7 years old already. You know what is good for you, and you read all the information for him. So let him know why he should not eat meat and why he should eat vegetarian, to be healthy, to be compassionate, and to save the planet in the urgency right now. So you print all this information of the urgency and the meat harmful diet, also from the UN, scientists, everything, you print it all out from our website and leave it to your husband. Let him slowly read it by himself. You don't even talk, also fine. And you tell your son he has to cry out whenever he forced to eat meat. He says, I don't want it, I don't want it. Tell the son to refuse it and cry to the father. Say, please don't force me. I don't like to eat meat because I love animal, because I love to save the planet. Or you have to do something then. Since you are so strong, you have to do something. You look strong to me, and you talk very strong. You know, there are two things. You're strong because you're ego, and you're not strong because you're good.
I'm sure about that.
So don't be strong in just ego, you know. Have to be strong in spirit and strong in a good way. Think about what to do.
Okay, understand. Thank you, Master.
You have to talk with your son also, okay? And have a good talk with your husband.
You.
Maybe there's something also there. It's not just about the vegetarian diet. Maybe you and your husband are not in accord. Maybe he feels lack of affection or something. That's why he do this, just to go against you, to revenge, to hurt you emotionally. So you have to have a good talk with him, or maybe more loving and tender to him. Then he might turn around. If both of you are too strong-willed and just try to against each other, then the son will suffer, because both of you will use him as a buffer zone, you know, as a shield against each other, and that's terrible for your son. Think about how to handle this situation. It depends. Have you been neglecting him emotionally? Have you been too strong or hard on him? Are you still loving him? Is he really a good person? If he is, then you have to work with him, okay? You work out the differences, work out the emotional issue, yeah, so that he feels secure and loved. And then he will be with you. Yes. Maybe he feel that you neglect him. So please try to see which is the real problem. Don't make your son suffer for both of your egos.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I hope you work out well with him, okay? I hope so.
Thank you again.
Master, the Bible says the God's kingdom is coming and will be realized on earth soon. During the last days, all those bad ones will be cut off, and the meek ones will survive and enjoy the paradise on earth. Master, could you please tell us what is the true meaning of this and what are the criteria for being a meek one? Thank you, Master.
The meek one is the one like you, the fellow initiates, yes, who are meek. Meek means you are not showing off. You are not utilizing your physical, mental strength to abuse anyone else, to harass anyone else, or to cause suffering for anyone. Because you're meek, you're humble. Suppose somebody go and harass you, or you don't even hit him back. Yes? Because you're meek. Meek doesn't mean you're a coward. Meek because you're humble, because you fear God, because you know the greatness of a person is not by doing harm to others or being violent to others, but to be good, yeah? To be humble, to be compassionate and loving. And that is the meaning of meek ones, that you will not defend, you will not go against anyone to protect your life. You even don't eat meat to live. You don't want to cause suffering for animals. You see, you rather eat simple meal, vegetarian food, to protect the others' lives. And now you're going out of your way in order to do God's work, in order to do what you think is noble and beneficial to everyone else. These are the meek ones that the Bible mentions. If you are not meek, then what else are you? You are a hero, but a very, very loving, humble, soft, yeah, non-violent hero. That is the meek one in the Bible. And those meek ones will be saved, bodies and soul. You see, that's why since you are initiated, your body become better, you're healthy, your mind is more clear, you understand what is good, what is bad, and you even act on what is good, and you even forsake what is bad. And you're feeling better all the time. So in this life, you're already saved. Save a lot of mental anguish, a lot of emotional problem, a lot of health danger. Yes, already saved in this life. And you already know heaven while alive. So, of course, if you leave this planet, you will go high. And that's the meek one.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, Master.
Yes.
Even with all the crises occurring on our planet, and even though as practitioners we try to focus on our spiritual path, still our minds can drag us towards the physical problem in life. How can we best keep our focus on our spiritual path, and should we be using all our time, energy and physical assets in working towards awakening humanity? Thank you, Master.
Yes, yes, that would be good. That's really good if you can focus all the time on a spiritual goal, yes, and use whatever time you can to awaken humanity. That is very noble and very good. It's laudable. But you see, sometimes because we're still living in this physical world, and sometimes it's not even our problem that affects us. Other people bring problems into our life. And we are interconnected with each other, with all humanity around us. So it's not possible to always avoid physical problems, yeah? And apart from that, we also have this hormone ragging within our body that keep us demanding on all kind of focus and desires instead of only on the spiritual path. But don't let all this bother you. If it's concerning physical need, you take care of whatever it needs to the minimum. You give your body food and drink enough to live. Yeah? And if you really need a partnership, then get a girlfriend, get married, yeah? For example, like that. Apart from that, nothing else you should worry about concerning physical body. And if it's a neighbor who needs help, then you help him what you can, only. And the rest, you meditate.
Thank you very much.
Meditate and help to awaken humanity. All right. No problem if you worry about physical aspect and desire sometime. Just try to fulfill it as best as you can, and then we do the rest, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
You good? Yeah, you feel okay otherwise?
Oh, yeah, it's fine. I was even thinking to stop eating and all that. Yeah.
Why? Why do you want to stop eating? Tell me.
Oh, to keep my life more simple.
Yeah, well, if you want to try and if you can, well, why not?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would think so, more simple, yeah? We don't need to have all these pans and pots. I don't have to go to the supermarket and don't have to go nowhere. I don't have to digest. Don't eat the bathroom, nothing, huh? Good imagination, yeah. Okay. You see, it depends on situation, huh? If you still can have food, then you eat. You eat less, yeah? And if you don't want to eat, it's fine. If you can keep your mind focused on a non-eating diet, then it's fine to me, yeah? Whatever you choose, eat best for you. As long as you harm no one else, and it's good for you, and you can do it, it's the best. Uh-huh. And that's why you worry about the food? Or anything else?
No, not about the food, but yeah, I try to focus on my spiritual path, but then physical thing is dragging me into the physical, like problems and work and
yes,
things like that.
Understand. Oh, so you don't have enough money to eat, or you don't want to go to work?
Yeah. I'm fine. Financially, I'm okay.
Yes.
Everything is okay. But sometimes I would like to be 100% into it. Yeah, and sometimes my mind tries to pull me to the other side. Oh, do this and all this physical stuff.
I understand.
Yeah.
Okay. So now instead of going to the extreme first, maybe you just eat light, you know, like eat soup every day first, juice or blending raw food, something more simple than cooking food. See how you feel, better or not, and less time consuming, then you could meditate more or do some more work, for example. Try to lessen the food, not the food intake, but different way, you know, more simple, like eat raw or eat blending juice or eat soup only, for example. See if you can, or if it helps you first, okay?
Yes, thank you.
How about that? One step at a time, huh?
Thank you very much.
We, a spiritual practitioner, could also go without food. So if the people who can go a little bit higher on the spiritual power, they can have more influence upon their mind, on their cells of the body. They can tell their cells of the body what to do. They can tell them, okay, now from now on we eat in air only, and the cell will listen. Or from now on we just live on a spiritual power from God, yeah? We are provided everything we need from God. I need some training, okay? Go slow
okay.
First. And there are also other people who are not even highly spiritual, but maybe they have not the karma of food in this lifetime. Then they also cannot eat. And so it's better they go without food, yeah? Because if they eat, they'll get sick or something also. Or it's just automatically that they don't eat. Okay? That is another reason for some people who can quit food easily. And if a person, a highly spiritual person, also don't have a food karma for this lifetime, then also very more easy for him to go without food. Otherwise, a person who also have a food karma in this lifetime but have a strong mind, power, and a spiritual force, then he can also quit eating food. We can change our life. So there are three categories, yeah? The one who are lower than middle third level, but had no good karmic food in this lifetime, also quit food easy. The one who are upper third level also have no food storage, you know, for this lifetime, then also can quit easily. And the third one is the one who has all kind of food karmic connection, but use the spiritual power to quit. Or circumstances help him to quit. Like sometimes we're trapped in some situation, we don't have food. Then we, at that time, no matter what level, please use the spiritual power to sustain yourself. Believe that God provides everything because man doesn't live from bread alone. Jesus said that.
Yeah.
Okay? And I know that. All right, love?
Thank you very much. I love you. Thank you.
I love you too. You're a good boy.
Thank you.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Aside from diligent meditation, the positive energy that comes from Supreme Master Television is a great way to help the world. Should we leave it on all the time, even when we're not watching it?
Yes, it helps. Put on low volume, yeah, or put it wherever it doesn't disturb you. Whenever you want to leave it on, it's good.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
What secrets or mysteries or technologies have yet to be revealed that will help save our planet? Thank you, Master.
Yes, there's one secret, the vegetarian diet. Very simple secret.
Thank you, Master.
Yeah. In the vegetarian diet, it contains many things. Yes, it's very simple solution, but it contains most of the principal goodness in life, I tell you. It contains all the five precepts in there. The first precept, thou shalt not kill. You see, if we are vegetarian, we don't even kill indirectly. Nobody will kill for us. Okay, that's the first. The second is, thou shalt not tell lie, not tell the truth. Yes, if you are vegetarian, you are true to yourself and true to the law of the universe. Like, we don't take other life to sustain our life. It is already reluctantly that we have to eat vegetarian diet to survive. But the trees, the plant will grow more. After, if we cut one branch, most of them will grow another 2-3 branch. So at least we do not destroy life as thus. Yes? So that's the second. The third, you shall not steal, eh? By being a vegetarian, we also keep that precept as well, automatically, because we don't steal another life. That is the worst thing to steal. No? And we do not steal the extra food that could be used to feed millions, 800 plus millions of hungry people because of the meat diet. So that is the greatest stealing. Not only we steal the animal's life, we steal the lives of our brothers and sisters around the world who could not afford food because the food has been all fed to the animals. And they have to sell even their food to feed the animals to the richer countries. So therefore, the food price is expensive and even non-existent for them. The food will be all gone to feed animals elsewhere and not distributed to them in their time of need. So that is another stealing. So for that, even to keep a vegetarian diet, we keep many precepts as well. And another precept is committing adultery if you eat meat. Maybe you also became less of the human quality and more of some of the animal's instinct. And then it's difficult for you to even control your sexual appetite. Yes? And then maybe you could even commit adultery or sexual misconduct due to the animal's influence of meat. It's not just the meat, it's not just the animal's instinct, it is the hormones, the antibiotic, and all kind of harmful substance that went into the meat before they're killed. And after they're killed, even all the preservatives and all the deadly bacteria that is inhabit in that piece of meat and all kind of thing that drives your hormone even more crazy. And it's easier for you to be unloyal to your partner, you see, or to commit even some sexual offense. So some sexual offenders, they are not even to blame completely. The society at large is to be blamed because they're feeding them all kind of things that is really crazy, harmful to their body, to their sane mental controlling capacity, beyond their comprehensive capability. All these terrible chemical and drugs go into the meat and then go into their body, drive them crazy. And for the average guy, it is already a miracle that he can even sustain himself and keep himself sane in this chaotic world.
Yes.
Yes. So now, meat diet even can cause you trouble in your relationship, in your adultery precept. And the last one is intoxicant. Even meat make you addictive. It's another kind of drug. You see what I mean? Another kind of addictive. And they also put all kind of things in there, make you addictive as well. So, just to be vegetarian, you keep the whole five precepts. Because people eat meat. They also cannot digest very well. So they need wine, you know, alcohol, to get more appetite and to digest easily. And then wine, alcohol, also intoxicant, and then lead them to another kind of unlawful act, you know, like drunken driving, yeah? Or brawling with other people in the bar and on the street, and degrading their dignity, all kind of things, or fighting, quarreling with family members, beating wife and kids. You know, most of the domestic abuse came from alcohol and drug. You see, so meat can even let people into another kind of intoxicants, doubling its effect and drive the man or the woman crazy and make them do a lot of things that they will regret for the rest of their life.
Benefits of drug abstinence and treatment. In the U.S., treatment for drug addiction has been shown to save lives, reduce crime, and rebuild families, along with 69% of those treated being drug-free 1 year after treatment, 64% reduction in arrests 1 year after treatment. A California USA study found that for every $1 invested in drug treatment, $7 was saved through reduced crime, health and welfare costs, and increased income stability. 60% of cocaine and heroin in the U.S. is consumed by people who get arrested in the same year. Thus, treatment that helps them to overcome drug addiction reduces crime and market demand for drugs. A doctor in Arizona, USA, identified a new outpatient treatment for methamphetamine addicts, showing an over 60% success rate in rehabilitation. 20 years of research in the U.S. has demonstrated that drug treatment programs are effective in reducing crime as well as improving the health and social function of participants. Drug-free workplace programs are found to result in lower absenteeism, fewer accidents, higher productivity, improved morale, better employee health, decreased use of and expenses for health benefits, lower corporate insurance premium costs, plus more.
Benefits of alcohol bans. Financial savings. A Canadian study estimates alcohol intervention programs could save 880 lives and $1 billion every year. Mortality. A 10% decline in vodka sales resulted in a significant decrease in alcohol-related deaths in Russia in 1 year. Exercising, drinking less alcohol, eating fruits and vegetables, and not smoking extends life expectancy by 14 years. Cancer. A World Cancer Research Fund study finds reducing meat and alcohol consumption decreases cancer risk. Other illnesses, the brain's regeneration and performance are increased once alcohol consumption ceases. Alcoholic hepatitis patients can gain complete recovery if the patient gives up alcohol and has a good diet. Bodybuilding.com states that bodybuilders who refrain from alcohol consumption experience benefits in terms of muscle gain, hydration, recovery, metabolism, and mental focus. Social implications. A New Zealand liquor ban resulted in 98% less liquor offenses, as well as a reduction in other crimes. Research in New Mexico, USA shows that Sunday bans on alcohol sales resulted in fewer collisions and traffic casualties. Alcohol-related crimes dropped by 15% following an alcohol ban in Aberystwyth, UK. An alcohol ban becomes permanent on the jetty area of Coffs Harbour City, Australia, due to its success in reducing crime. Youth. In the U.S. state of Florida, raising the legal drinking age from 18 to 21 significantly reduced auto accident-related fatalities. A voluntary ban of alcohol sales to youth under 21 in the UK's Marks Village is made permanent as crime and antisocial behavior is reduced. An alcohol ban in US colleges helps overall alcohol abstention and reduces bouts of drunkenness and secondhand effects of drinking. Plus more.
So if just keep a vegetarian diet, you keep all the precepts. That's why I told you, the only mystery is vegetarian diet. Huh?
Yes, Master. Thank you, Master.
The only cure is vegetarian diet, the only secret, okay? Then we save the whole world and we will live in heaven hereafter.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome, my love.
Hi, Master.
Hi.
Hey, Master. With the serious environmental health of our precious planet, every day there is some new catastrophe happening somewhere in the world. Is there more to the big picture than just environmental imbalance? Is there maybe a preparation of sorts occurring with regard to an ascending process for our beautiful planet? Is she going to be safe? Also, is there any assistance available and allowable from our brothers and sisters from other planets, in case we need it? Thank you, Master.
You are very welcome. Regarding to your last question, they are helping quietly already, yes? But this is a very easy problem. We can solve it ourselves just by being veg. How more simple can it be? Only if the human listen. All they do is just be veg, and everything else will take care of itself. How simple, huh? But only if anybody is listening, all right? Now, concerning the ascending of our planet, that is the universal plan for our planet, that we should catch up, that we should ascend with other higher spiritually developed planet. That is the plan. But the human are given free will, you see, and for that free will, they have not been using it wisely. That is the problem. And now I'm calling everyone to use their free will in a better way, to free themselves from bad karmic retribution, to free themselves from guilt, free themselves from blood on their hands, free themselves from, blood debt, free themselves from hell retribution hereafter. Free themselves from destroying the only home that they love, which is our planet. Free themselves from the murderous status that they are in by eating meat. You see, freeing themselves from all the crimes, past and present. So if they will be vegetarian, everything will be forgiven. Everything will be well and good. The planet will be restored, the animal will be thankful, the human will be healthy, and all will be happy and blessed. That's all there is to do, be veg. Nothing else heaven asked from us. Nothing else we really have to do. Nothing else the other planet even need to help us. Very simple, be veg. So we cannot demand in heaven to help us any more than this. It's just to be veg. So if we have more urgent and justified cause of desperation or urgency, of course other planet will help or heaven will help. But it's just to be vegetarian And if we cannot do that, then I'm sorry, we don't deserve any help.
Yes, can I understand that?
I am sorry. I truly am. But the thing is, people are not too much aware of this, being, you know, indoctrinated too long in the meat diet, believing that it's healthy and good for them and necessary for them. Therefore, we have to try to reverse this concept. And it's not easy for all of us, but I beg you all to do it. Continue, save as many as you can, and then if most people are good, then of course our planet will ascend to a better level of consciousness, equal with other planets in the hierarchy of the galaxy. And then, you know, of course, everything will be good. What else can I tell you? I cannot tell you if the planet is going to be safe or not. I can only tell you that I have positive feeling. And that if we are working hard, and with the help of all the vegetarian, fruitarians, breatharian, watarian, I mean all the non-meat eaters out there, if they're all helping us, and even the meat eaters, if they're helping us, you know, also, then the planet will be safe. I love everyone. I want them to be safe and sound, but for their own good only. Not just to keep them alive and they continue to make others suffer, because in that way they will suffer themselves, now or later on. So that's not the kind of love that I want to give to people on this planet. My kind of love is to awaken their own love. Then they will be well here and hereafter. That is a true love that we can give to others. And that is true love that I can give to you and everyone out there.
Yes, I can understand. It'd be like if I was to tidy my daughter's bedroom all the time, she would never learn to keep her own bedroom clean. And she would be spoilt.
We have to love with wisdom, yeah? We have to love wisely. I want to wake them up and save themselves. That's the best for them now and later on, after they die, okay? Otherwise, physical body is not much to talk about, okay? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Master.
You're welcome.
What I mean is,
for you and for all the initiates, do not be in despair, you know?
Yeah.
Do not be pessimistic. Just because I say I don't know if the planet is going to be safe or not. I just have a very positive feeling that if we continue our effort, our sincerity will bear fruit.
Yes, I see the results around me every day.
Yeah, you do?
Two new vegetarian people at work. I don't preach to them, but they just take the example. They ask me and I just answer truthfully.
Wow.
There's so much good information around now, so many facts that we can use, and they speak for themselves, you know. We don't really have to preach, because the scientific evidence stands up for itself.
Wonderful. Your positive example it speaks volumes, and it's also because maybe you are humble and you're just casual and natural in yourself, you know. Because some people are vegetarian, but they have this attitude, you know, I'm holier than thou. But if you're just natural and casual and, you know, sincere in your effort, and knowing that anyone else, even though they're eating meat, it's not their sin, it's not their fault. They had just been misled.
Exactly,
and you have
yeah.
more compassion to them, and then that's how it connects.
People don't realize that they're being ripped off.
Yes, that's right. So compassion and love we must have in dealing with anybody, no matter how sinful they are or meat-eating or not. That is what we must have, yes. It's sometimes more difficult with family members, of course, but still we have to try. Hmm?
We can only show them the good example.
Yes, it's good, it's good. But you're also lucky and you're very positive and you're highly elevated spiritual energy affect people also. You see, like attract like, mostly like that. Yes. So I'm very proud of you. Go ahead, continue, okay? Everybody else also.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
You look fantastic.
Thank you, mate.
Yeah, you're welcome, mate.
Master, if most of the soul are already elevated to the third level now, why is it that our physical selves are so far behind, and why don't we begin to act more like third level beings while on earth?
I told you, because they have been indoctrinated, they've been misled, and that's why they cannot be even elevated to a middle third. They are only elevated to the lower third, which is already out of the influence of the second level most of the time, which is already very good. That means if they die, they don't have to reincarnate it into the suffering level, and they have a chance to meet the spiritual master if they reincarnate as a human being, or they could continue from the lower third level upward. You know, it takes just longer time than you guys, because you are initiated and you practice yourself, and your spiritual awakening will help you. You see what I mean? In this lifetime and the next. But they are also being graced, being blessed to uplift them a little bit up to the a lower level of the third plane. So it's a big difference. That's why I told you, even if they eat meat, it's not their fault, it's not their sin. It's just they have been misled. They are really innocent. So all we do is trying to waken more people up. Yeah, not all of them are elevated. Nah? I mean, the majority has been elevated. And some are still bad. And they also still can influence on this world, other people. But because we are doing this and the people already elevated, they are awakened quicker than ever before. Just in a short while, people join in the vegetarian circles because their spirit already elevated. We need more help. The people need to help us more. You know, the vegetarian people are the non-meat eater, including breatharian, waterian, solarian, fruitarian, etc. They will help us more from now on. And then we will get the critical mass quicker. And then the people will be more awakened quicker. It is one thing to let them go in your car for a ride, and it's another thing to drive the car themselves and to buy their own car. Even if they have a driver license already, maybe they haven't got enough money to buy the car yet. And the family don't let them buy a car, or the friends say a car no good for you, or they are still shopping around undecided which car they buy. Okay? So we be patient and hope for the best, pray for the best, and do the best we can.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, love.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you for your love and for trying very hard and for being good people. Even if you're not doing anything, you are vegetarian, I'm already very thankful, very proud of you. Okay? So keep going in your noble direction, and I shall see you soon. Ciao.
Bye-bye, Master. Thank you. We love you, Master.
I love you, and heaven loves you. Thank you.